Paul Harrell, weekdays from 4 to 6. Learn more at paulharrell.com.
It matter, that's the question we should all be asking ourselves, or whether you consider yourself somebody on the left or the right, or somebody in the middle. We would all agree personal individual liberty is a good thing. I hope so. Although we may have different definitions about what personal freedom really is. Hey, joining us now to talk about this with the Arkansas Tea Party Alliance, we have David Crow joins us back again. David, welcome.
Hey, Paul. I'm so glad to be back with you, man.
It's always great to have you on, David. I want to make sure, because we're getting closer to the September 16th. It's a Saturday, September the 16th. From 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Robinson Center, new ballroom overlooking the Arkansas River, the Doubletree by Hilton, down in Little Rock, the third annual Arkansas Tea Party Alliance Convention, 2017. Liberty doesn't matter. This is not just for Tea Party people. If you're a limited government person, you've never been to a Tea Party in your life, you need to go. You need to get tickets from this. You need to go and experience and get all the good information and make great contacts with limited government people, don't they, David?
They sure do. And, you know, it's fun to see the number of people that are not in the Tea Party that come to these events. We've, like you mentioned, we've been doing this for 3 years, and we have a lot of people that show up on that last day, and they want to come, and they're welcome. And we have a little food left, a little extra food, so we're able to feed them up. But the tickets are going fast, and we're actually 31 days out, and that's a little over, what is that, a little over 4 weeks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's going to be a special day, and I hope many, many come. We're anticipating quite a crowd, so it should be a good time. Great breakouts and good speakers and just good fellowship and friends, and got a continental breakfast and lunch and just good times.
If you're watching us online, it depends on where you're watching us. But if you're watching us on Facebook, this isn't for you because you're already on the Facebook page or you can see it. But go to Facebook.com/Paul Talk Show and you can get their tickets. We've pinned a post about the Arkansas Tea Party Alliance at the top of the Facebook page. And it's linked to the way you can buy tickets online and let them know that you're coming. David, I am curious because I know you keep up with the news. I know you're a news hound. I know you're a conservative. Did you by any chance see the article where Governor Asa Hutchinson announced $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 increases in government workers' salary, specifically ones at the top of the food chain?
Yes, I did. That's quite a lengthy article as well. It was bits and pieces here and there, and HR was my chosen field for many years, and wage and salary administration was one of those things that fell out under human resources, so I'm quite familiar with what was being discussed in this article.
Okay, good. Then I'm really – so it's a pay plan, and maybe I – feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, but I know, you know, you have a new pay plan, but in the private sector, is there such a thing in revising what a pay plan is? And if so, would it ever result in such – I mean, you had just several people, and we don't even know the list we can get it of people that made the $19,000 increases, but the $20,000 and up, I mean, it's just a very long list. Is that how they work in the private sector?
There are times where you might have a few, it's because you've done substantially different things with the job. What they tried to characterize here in this, and frankly, wage and salary administration is one of those things that is very difficult to totally understand. It's impossible to know the scope of what they did. With 60,000 some odd employees in state government, this plan was primarily targeted at the about 30,000 people, and some of the numbers in here don't gee and haw with you know the realities of the wage and salary, you know, numbers that they talked about, because they talked about 1% here and 2% here and things like this, and then you do get the people that are making substantially larger increases of $20,000 to $40,000, but then also they have a portion down here where the pay scales were shifted by 6%, and which covered $1 billion of salary on one and $1.2 billion on another one, and The total salaries is about $3.2 billion. So, and that's just salaries. And it doesn't take into consideration the other benefits, which adds to probably another $1 billion. So we're talking about $4 billion worth of employee compensation for just this group of people. So, but to answer your question specifically, there are companies that do consolidate work, find that they're underpaying various jobs by substantial amount, and they will make those adjustments oftentimes when they're employing or trying to recruit for a specific area. But to do it all at one time, it's just smacks of bureaucracy, and it's regretful that they've chosen to let this thing lie for many, many years and not make corrections. But the other thing it says to me is that I know for a fact that other states around us have about 30% fewer employees. So what you have is you have a mammoth organization here that you're trying to pay to do perform work, and you've got you have an overstaffed government, and they're just trying to keep up with a little bit of pay increases to make cost of living increases, and the way this whole thing is structured just doesn't seem the right thing from my vantage point.
Yeah, I like what you said. It smacks of bureaucracy. I think in government there's going to be some positions that you have to maybe look at what the market is being offered. You know, what is the market doing in the private sector? But the governor said in the paper this is going to make us more competitive with the private sector.
Right.
And I'm just not so sure every single job, first of all, I mean, some of these government jobs are not in the private sector. That's why they are government jobs, you know?
Right. And that's I was talking about this with someone recently. It's, once you start doing salary administration and you have to go out and survey, you look at competencies, the necessary skills, required to perform the job, the educational background and the like, and the various things that make up a position, and you have to go out and match those jobs with other comparable companies, and therefore what they end up doing oftentimes here is they compare against other states where they have comparable jobs, and hopefully they're not choosing to compare to New York and California and other locations where their cost of living is substantially greater, and therefore you would see a substantial need for increase in compensation when you're trying to compete in those areas. But for the kind of work that we have here, I can't imagine that there's many jobs that they would have to compete on a nationwide basis. So their comparables would be comparing against Mississippi, Oklahoma, Texas, and Louisiana, and some other non-skilled positions in the local market, mm-hmm. you know, here in Little Rock and some surrounding area in Central Arkansas. But outside of that, there shouldn't be that many jobs that they have to go nationwide for.
I mean, my question go ahead, David.
No, I'm just saying it can get very confusing, and I don't want to try to go down to the weeds on my conversation with you about it, but it's a highly skilled technical thing to put together a wage and salary administration program. And when you have this many employees, it is a difficult task. I was quite surprised by the number of senators, 34-0, and House 93-0, that voted for this bill when it was passed, this act, 365. I was quite surprised by the number of people that voted for it.
I mean they didn't see these numbers. I mean they might not have known.
No.
The deputy commissioner of education, this person is going to get a 36% salary increase, which comes out to $41,000 overnight. One pay period to the next,
right.
She gets a $41,713 increase. She was already making over $100,000. Now she's going to make $156,000. I mean, I think there'd be some people that would say that that's extreme. I mean, the question is the deputy commissioner of education going to quit if she doesn't get the $41,000 raise? And I don't think I don't think the answer is yes. I think they'd have stayed right where they were.
That gets to that issue of what are you comparing against? Are you comparing against the local market? Are you comparing against the nationwide salary survey? And it, you know, it's hard to tell, but by that kind of increase, it would say to me that they probably have chosen to look at it on a higher level when you're talking about management. Now, there are some skill positions that they've talked about with computer works, nurses, and the like, where they had to do some things to be competitive. And that probably was on a local basis. They looked at those. Why they were that far behind that would require them to give those kind of large increases is quite surprising to me. One of the things that was said in here that I did like was they said that they were going to try to go to a merit-based program, is what I used to always advocate when I was in industry. And it's something that it would be is something that would be critical. But in the context of that, you really have to get your numbers, your manpower numbers in line with reality, which what's going on out there in the world. I wish they would not only compare against salaries, but I wish they would compare numbers of employees with the surrounding states as well. I think they'd see that we were probably, with my study that I did, I found that we were about 30% plus overstaffed in government.
Yeah. And yet they say this is going to help us make the government more lean, which, I mean, you know, I don't believe that for a second. That's really not the goal here. The goal here, in my opinion, I mean, if we shift gears here and go politically, feel free to disagree with me on this. But, I mean, this is the governor, essentially, in my opinion, saying, hey, I'm going to make these people in my executive branch happy. They're going to get excited about another 4 years of the Hutchinson administration, because, I mean, I just handed out 40, 37, 34, 31, 28, $25,000 raises to a whole bunch of people. And we haven't even looked at the ones that got the $19,000 raises or the $15,000 raises.
Right, right. Yeah, when you get a raise like that, and somebody calls you that was responsible for it, and they say jump, you're just going to say how high.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Yeah, it's no doubt. There was a lot of those that were fairly substantial and surprisingly so. I just can't imagine we were that far behind. But when you do have turnover rate up in the double digits, teens and the like, there are some issues that have to be addressed, and they in this case believe that compensation is going to correct it.
And I get that. I said yesterday, look, information systems and technology, IT, you know, you may have to look at the market for that. You may have to say, okay, the chief security officer for, you know, information systems, you know, we need to pay him $120,000 or $150,000 to get somebody competent. Now, the question is, do they eliminate the people beneath him that, you know, aren't really necessary? And that hasn't happened to my knowledge. And I'm just spitballing here, but it just seems to me this, first of all, it doesn't look good. It certainly highlights the fact, you know, the average citizen, the average person in Arkansas, the taxpayer who's working to pay for all of this, they're not getting a call from their boss getting a $37,000 raise from one pay period to the next. You know, so it just reinforces that, hey, you know what? Well, you work for the government, and the government's not like us. The government's not like the rest of us. And that's not healthy.
No, it's not. And it's regretful because, and the governor was correct. He says, we're going to take, this is not going to be happy. There are a lot of people not going to be happy about this. And that is very true. When the people look at those numbers, and it's regretful that government is the way it is, and that they're bloated as they are, and to see that there's that many people working in government that getting those kinds of increases, and that you and I have to pay for all those increases, that is not going to make a lot of people happy.
Mm-hmm. Hey, before we go, David, have you had a chance to dive more into Jacob Bundrick and Jeremy Horpendahl's piece of the Center for Research and Economics that really verify your numbers that you found?
Yes, my goodness. When I read that document, and I still have more studying to do in it, but it confirmed a lot of what I wrote in my my no way did they did not say that article about the spending problem that we have in Arkansas, but it confirms it. They worked with real numbers from 2015. My numbers there was 2014. Mine were 2015 numbers, but they coincide very well. And the 2016 estimates just say that we continue to grow government and the size of government. And I recall back a few years ago when the governor said that they were going to cut the size of government, that they were going to reduce the number of employees, and they were going to freeze employment, and they were going to cut back on the spending. And what we've seen is $400 million increase in spending, and we saw them go after another $400 million of our tax dollars this past session. And I don't think things are changing in the direction that we were promised that they would, but that's something we'll have to deal with the next election.
And I appreciate your expertise in the private sector on the salary increases, but to me, it doesn't really bode well. We're not going to solve our out-of-control spending problem by giving people massive raises, I don't think.
No, I agree. I agree. That is, it's not, it might cause a few of those people to stick around a little bit longer, but I think that the problems in government are more than just salary increases.
Yeah.
I think it's substantial issues related to just employment issues within the bowels of the government there.
David,
you know, when you're working on a job and there's...
Go ahead. Go ahead,
I'm
David.
Sorry, Paul.
No, you go ahead.
Sorry. When there's four of you in the department that are working on a job that really would only take about two people, and you're cooling your heels for 50% of the time that you're at work, you know, that's demoralizing.
Yeah.
And I've seen it where we've taken private companies and we've reduced staff by 50%. We've increased compensation substantially for a lot of people, and they had a full-time job and they worked, and the morale went straight through the ceiling.
Yeah.
And I think that what we have is a government that's bloated, and they're trying to fix it by given additional compensation. They're not going to fix it. What they have to do is to reduce the size of government and you know, increase the efficiencies in government. And I think what you'd have is a workforce that's substantially more excited about working than they are today.
David Crow with the Arkansas Tea Party Alliance. We appreciate it. It's the third annual Liberty Doesn't Matter convention. Get your tickets, facebook.com/Paul Talk Show. David, we appreciate it. Folks, we got to go to break. Back in just a moment.